It took less than 10 minutes for these cybersecurity researchers to hack into this electric vehicle charger.
All I need is to open it up with a tool, pop out one of the hardware chips, and then we can read it and find your personal data.
EV chargers are increasingly vulnerable to cyberattacks that could expose sensitive data, compromise Wi-Fi networks, and in a worst-case scenario, bring down power grids.
We've created attacks that could be used to switch on thousands and thousands of EV batteries at once. That could cause power spikes on the grid, which could cause blackouts.
This cybersecurity expert is going to walk us through other hacking demos to understand the risks posed by EV chargers and what could be done to minimize these vulnerabilities.
So I suppose we're the good guys. Our job is to break things to help organizations make them better.
Ken Munro is the co-founder of Pentest Partners, a cybersecurity research company based in the United Kingdom that specializes in what's known as white hat hacking.
We're brought in by organizations to hack them in a controlled way to find the bugs so they can get fixed, and then the bad hackers can't get in anymore.
At other times, Pentest carries out independent research on products, like EV chargers.
So this is the wall box.
Pentest discovered this at-home charger had two major security flaws. The first one, which we saw earlier, is tied to the hardware.
The chance is lower because someone's taking a big risk to be outside your home, but actually the consequences can be more serious because they're getting very personal information. When we're by the charger, we could pop the front off and take some of the hardware out, and from there we could get much more sensitive data. You could access things like the homeowner's Wi-Fi key. They might be able to intercept your passwords, potentially stealing your banking credentials.
Pentest Partners says there's a security flaw in the charger's processor, which runs on a hardware platform called Raspberry Pi Compute Module 3.
This is the Raspberry Pi from inside the wall box. Raspberry Pis are great for education and prototyping, but they're not really for a commercial product like this.
Wallbox used this hardware in a 2018 version of its chargers. The module is not currently listed for industrial use on Raspberry Pi's website.
It's an easy way of getting to market fast. Unfortunately, it's not great for security when you're delivering hundreds of thousands of them.
Pentest Partners says this hardware bug hasn't been fixed in the 2018 chargers, but Wallbox says newer versions of the product no longer have this vulnerability. In a statement, a Wallbox spokesperson said that in an effort to adapt to the latest regulations and the highest standards, they launched a new hardware platform in 2022, which includes advanced security measures. Raspberry Pi did not respond to requests for comment, but Munro says newer versions of Raspberry Pi hardware now have stronger cybersecurity. Hackers could also infiltrate the same charger remotely.
Probably the easiest way that we found to get into an EV charger was over the internet, compromising the cloud platform.
Charging stations are connected through an entire ecosystem of platforms, like smartphone apps, cloud services, and Wi-Fi networks.
That's the big problem. That connectivity has brought everything together. So often one mistake in the cybersecurity can lead to a compromise of all.
For example, Pentest Partners found that the Wallbox charger didn't properly verify who the user was when the charger was controlled by its smartphone app.
And as a result, that meant that we could connect to anyone's charger and tell it to turn off and on, for example. So my colleague Dave's in the lab now, and he's going to show just how easy it is to turn on and off again. And there we go.
Pentest Partners says it told Wallbox about the software bug, and the company says it fixed the issues shortly after. A Wallbox spokesperson said they take potential vulnerabilities incredibly seriously and immediately fixed the software flaw when they were alerted to the issue in 2021. But even when software bugs like this are fixed, users can forget to update their devices.
The number one thing you can do for your security, whether it's in your EV, on your phone, your home computer, whatever it is apply software updates.
And that's just one of the ways a charger can be hacked. Sometimes the vulnerabilities are connected to design oversights, like this charger from Project EV.
So this is one of the chargers we had most concerns about. We popped it open, and obviously there's lots of charging technology in there. But the bit that worried us is all we needed to access it was the serial number on the side.
The serial number acted as a credential to access the charger's software. With that, Pentest could hijack user accounts and prevent charging.
And unfortunately, all those serials were sequential. So once we had one, we could just iterate up and down and take control of all the chargers.
Project EV says it fixed this flaw by updating its software. In a statement, a spokesperson said the company treats cybersecurity very seriously, and it takes every precaution, and the individual user must take personal responsibility to upgrade their apps to ensure they have the latest security protocols for their product. He added that all current chargers meet the highest security standards today. But cybersecurity experts say other cracks aren't that hard to find. Multiple studies have found bugs that could allow hackers to connect to a charger remotely and install malware. This opens the door for an attacker to overheat an EV battery, hijack a Wi-Fi network, or even take control of an entire vehicle. But it's the cumulative impact of these types of attacks that could cause the most damage.
So the power grid is designed to work at a relatively steady state, and you have a big problem if you have a huge surge in demand or a huge dip in demand. And either of these could be caused by a coordinated set of EVs all of a sudden charging or not charging.
In a 2020 study, NYU researchers modeled a hypothetical scenario where a group of hackers could use less than 1,000 EV chargers to take down the Manhattan power grid.
We've inadvertently created weapons that could be used against us by foreign powers.
The growing complexities of EVs and the networks they're connected to makes protecting them from attacks even harder.
You have many more lines of code in your vehicle than were used in the rockets that went to the moon. There's just this enormous attack surface. In general, the more features you have, the more ways people can go and attack it.
And while reported hacks have been relatively minor so far, the risks are only growing as companies, governments, and consumers rush to install more chargers.
There was a case in the south of England where a charger was hacked and started displaying pornography. We've seen a case at the start of the Russia-Ukraine conflict where Russian EV chargers started going offline with hacked messages. So it is happening.
The Electric Vehicle Charging Association is a trade group for the public charging network industry in North America. It said that the industry understands the importance of cybersecurity and takes it very seriously. Right now, there are more than 160,000 public chargers scattered throughout the U.S., and the 2021 Infrastructure Act provides funding to help build 500,000 more. But in this rush to expand EV charging infrastructure, experts say cybersecurity has taken a back seat.
Everyone wants to move as fast as they can to get first mover advantage. Lots of manufacturers rushing to get their product to market to get market share, but not quite getting cybersecurity nailed along the way.
The U.S. doesn't have any regulations around EV cybersecurity, but some experts say it may take a major cyber attack on EV infrastructure before the industry and lawmakers step up prevention efforts. For now, Munro recommends consumers help take matters into their own hands.
Make sure you choose a good, strong password that you don't use anywhere else. And this is perhaps my cynical nature of being a security researcher. I don't actually connect my chargers to the internet. I prefer to keep them unconnected and dumb, if you will.